Hi Sweros, this is Pratyusha from 2nd CEC, RGSC Asifabad. My guide teacher name is Venkatesham sir and our college principal sir name is Dr. Rajaram sir garu. So today topic is Green Revolution and its impacts on Indian economy. There are four subtopics are there. First one, the Indian agriculture after independence, the Green Revolution in India. The third one is modern agriculture in India or Green Revolution too. The fourth one is vertical farming. So before going to the topic, we may discuss about the agriculture. What is the agriculture? We may eat and we may eat for the health of agriculture. Yes or no? Yes. And every living creature depend on agriculture only. So we are discussing about now Indian agriculture after independence. So if you are seeing those pictures, what did you understand? The man is preparing soil and the women are weeding or harvesting. So after more than of 600 years of colonial rule in India, received its impact and received its independence from the British Empire rule on August 15th, 1947. Means they are ruling our India as a slaves. That's why our Indian agriculture system is not developed. The large section of population was about 3/4 mainly depend on agriculture for the employment and for the food and for consumed by the farming families and landlords, and the majority of population lived in rural areas complete with the great low productivity because of in rural areas there is no any infrastructure and there is no any latest technology to improve the agriculture products. That's why the farmers are getting very low productivity. And the purpose of the Indian government is taking decisions of new methods of agriculture system. It will be implementations in the midst of 1960s. So what did you understand means the living creature or humans in agriculture system, there is no any result to succeed. So it were the Green Revolution is started in 1960s. So the Green Revolution in India. The first Green Revolution means it refers to HYV seeds and irrigation and pesticides and insecticides and fertilizers. These are known as Green Revolution. So HYV seeds means we can consider rice, sugar, paddy, cereals, pulses, millets. These are HYV seeds. Means in agriculture field, we will crop on that seeds, then we get good yield. Okay. Irrigation. Irrigation means without irrigation facilities, we cannot do the cultivation or any get of new profit. For the irrigation only, it is succeed. And pesticides. Now, in olden days, there is no any pesticides to use in agriculture system. And also fertilizers. In olden days, there is the farmers are using natural manure. But when the 20th century, the people using fertilizers means these are prepared in factories. These are known as the chemical fertilizers. So for these four components, we will consider to get a good profit. We have to consider a Green Revolution. The word of Green Revolution was started in an economist in the country of American, William Smith Gunn, after Mexico country economist Norman Borlaug was introduced in world. Further, the government of India taking decisions in agriculture system are responsible for the how to development of agriculture. Means they have to take in the sum of technical and institutional is known as the self-fertilizer revolution. So, if you are observing these pictures, what they are doing? By the using of machines, by the using of tractors, the man is cultivating. Means, in that days, there is no any tractors or machines. They have to cultivate by the harvesting or anything. The man is doing spraying the chemicals on crops. So, in India, the peoples are suffering from more problems of agriculture. So, our Indian economist or scientist started Green Revolution in the year of 1966 to 67 with a wheat crop in Kharif season. So, our Indian agriculture basically depend on monsoon rainfalls. The monsoon rainfalls is not sufficient in the country every year. So, our Indian agriculture productivity is very low. So, every peoples are should depend on rainfall only. But it is not available because of pollution is very more. So, our peoples are getting a new idea to development of green revolution. Then we cultivate various types of crops and getting good yield without depend on monsoon rainfalls. So, if you observing the projects, it is a one type of natural resource, means water resource. For the dams or projects, we can save our water. But for the supply to the agriculture fields, then we will cultivate easily. And it is also in that slide, we can consider second one slide. There is a irrigation facilities. By the solar irrigation facilities, we can grow the crops easily. After cultivation of crops, we will cut the maize or rice, anything by the machines. It is a new technology. And also, the government of India began Green Revolution in the year of 1960s through the application of modern agriculture technique used to improve the productivities. Means, if you are observing these three, by the projects and solar and by the cutting of these machines, these are modern agriculture techniques to improve the agriculture products. So, it has a pilot projects in our country, was called as a intensive agriculture development program, means to development of agriculture in the days, there is no any searching or anything to development of anything. So, our Indian economist or scientist M.S. Swaminathan was considered to move a pilot project in our country. Mainly, they have to doing pilot projects in 7 districts first. Later, it was extended by the 114 districts. So, it refers to the HYV seeds, means high yielding varieties of seeds required proper irrigation system and proper irrigation facilities and extended use of fertilizers and pesticides and insecticides, growing more of food with HYV seeds. Without HYV seeds, we cannot get more of yield. And fertilizers and water is called Green Revolution. So, there are third modern agriculture in India, though it was started in 21st century, and there is a three subtopics are there. Contents, the poly greenhouse farming and drip irrigation and sprinkling system. If you observe these slides, it is like a den or hole of house to grow to plant a green plant. Means the poly greenhouse means it returns a good poly greenhouse enables to grow the crops throughout the year, not depend on 1 or 2 months or 1 or 2 seasons. It is a throughout year we will cultivate easily. By this system, we will get good yield and we will save our land also. By this system, the most of the peoples are living in their houses. Means to get a good profit means there are, and also here not only depend on one or two seasons, it are irrespectively seasons means we have to cultivate any season also. It is available of any seasons, and polygreen house is very useful to us. It is a modern technology and modern system of our green revolution. It is known as we consider the green revolution too. Before green revolution is started, it is not any benefits or anything, and in that polygreen house farming, we can get the quality of produce it better than the open field cultivation. Means in open field cultivations, we have to cultivate in any crops. In that there is a, if you are taking the example of rainy seasons, in that season, if more rains also, the cultivation of crops is collapsed. If more summer, in summer we have to take the example of summer. In summer there is a more of it, then the crops are very dried. So it is a better than the open field cultivation. It is a very better than the open field cultivation. So next one is sprinkling system. The sprinkling irrigation is a method of applying water to get a controlled manner in that similar to rainfalls. Means for this system we can apply water to that plants. By that system we can control our water savage. Do you have any ideas in that water loss? Okay, if you are mentioned the stone borders or saplings or harvesting pits, it is like a similar to rainfalls. For this system we can, a large amount of water is absorbed by the canals soil before reaching the plant, and also it is a modern device of watering is known as a sprinkler. Mainly the concept is applying water to dirt plants. For that it will reach to the fastly, and if one season also it get more profit, in that system we will get more of benefits. And next one is drip irrigation. The drip irrigation is a type of micro irrigation system that has a potential to save the water, and by allowing a new nutrients, and also water drips slowly to the roots of plants. Means the method is applied when the water is availability is very poor. Then we apply water drips, then we reach to the plant and get a good yield. For that whatever it crop, we can get more of benefits. And it consists a large tube followed by the small tubes attached to a motor. Means here a longer tubes, it will pass to the that plant, and we can save the water in that plant. And water reaches to the plants, and drip drop by drop is known as the drip irrigation. Next one is vertical farming. Vertical farming it is the latest technology and latest system, vertical farming. Recently, 2 years back it is implemented. So for this system we can get good benefits. For this, without using of lands, we can plant a new crops, or various types of crops we can plant. Mainly the lettuce are being grown in vertical farming. Wherever in the case of rooftops, if any buildings, we can plant in rooftops, and beside of balconies, kids veggies and some of fruits we can get. Not only fruits, we can cultivate any vegetables or flowerings or any latest designs of bouquets. We have to planting various types of various types of crabs in that farming system. Some crabs are growing in India. Not only some of crabs are some of anything. Various types of crabs are growing in India. And the modern ideas of vertical farming is indoor farming. Means without trapping in outside, we can farming in indoorly. And it is known as the controlled enrollment agriculture technology. With this system, we can control the enrollment in agriculture technology. It will be more of benefit because of to saving of pollution. Means most of the peoples are doing very doing pollution in most of it is polluted area. So for this system, the agriculture is getting a good profit. For this system, we can save the enrollment in agriculture purpose. And vertical farming is a practice of growing produce in vertically stacked layers. Means it is a practice can use the soil and hydroponic and aeroponic. Means without using of land, we can plant in with the water also. It is used in most of in near of cities. This farming is used in near of cities, and for this system we can save our land also. So these are the systems of our green revolution. These are the main, these four subtopics are very important to improvement of agriculture. If we use the vertical farming or modern agriculture techniques, then we get good yield in that. Okay, so vertical farming for these systems we can improvement our agriculture products. Before independence, there is no any result, there is no any benefit in that. So for this system we can improve the agriculture products. So thank you. The first of all, I will say IPS Praveen Kumar Sir garu, because of he is given more opportunity for us. It is a wonderful opportunity for me. That's why I thankful to IPS Praveen Kumar Sir. Next, I thankful to my guide teacher Venkatesham Sir garu. Thank you, sir, for giving wonderful courageous message to me. And also I thankful to the Dr. Rajaram Sir garu, college of our principal. Thank you, sir, for giving a wonderful message and encourage for me. Thank you for all.